to know Artie Moreno liked the Stars, and he wanted to keep Mike Trout badly, and we did know Mike Trout was comfortable there, as Ken said. But as far as the number goes, I think that's about right. I mean, this is clearly the best player in the game. Mookie Betts is a fantastic player. I thought Mookie Betts should have won two MVPs, not one. Incredible player, but as Ken did say, he's not quite Mike Trout. Mike Trout has an 8 WAR every year. Mike Trout has had 10 WAR in a year. He is, I think, on a level by himself in terms of his play on the field and his historical importance to baseball. So, I don't think it's going to impact a lot of people. It's probably going to impact Betts in terms of probably setting the ceiling for Betts. Not to insult him or anything, $430 million is a nice ceiling, but I'm with Ken. I think we're looking at $400 million. Could be a little bit less, something in that range for Mookie Betts when he is able to get a deal done. And obviously Boston is a team that wants to keep Mookie Betts, helped them win the World Series last year.
Sure. And I want to give Moreno and his guys and women who work for L.A. a lot of credit here. They did not let him get to the point where he said, no, I don't want to talk about a deal. I'm going to be a free agent, so I want to see what's out there. They took care of it now. And I think they deserve a lot of credit, John.
Yeah, this was the time to do it, 2 years to go. A player of that caliber, you're not going to sign him with 1 year to go or less. So this was it. I think people understood that. I wasn't sure that they were going to be able to do it. Congratulations to them for doing it. They made clear he was never going to be on the block. They weren't trading him regardless. I give them credit for that. They were very honest about that up front. He was the only player, I think, in Major League Baseball who was 100% untouchable, although others are close. He's the one who was 100% untouchable, and they said that from the start. And you're right, give them credit for getting this done. Artie Moreno does love the Stars. I think it's great for them. I would like to see them get some pitching now to go along and help them get in the playoffs again and maybe get a chance at the World Series. But he certainly has spent a lot of money. As you referenced, $184 million, he bought the team, so he's probably up $2 billion on that deal, so he maybe has some money for pitching too.
Yeah. Let me ask you this: how close are they to winning?
I think they have a good team. I don't think they're as good as the Astros in their division, so it's going to be tough for them to win a division. I could see them making the playoffs as a wild card. As I said, I'm a little concerned about their pitching, and they've had a lot of bad luck, a lot of bad fortune in recent years. With the pitching, obviously, we've got Haney also already with a little bit of a situation, not going to start the season with the team, and he's one of their better pitchers. I think that if they got another starter or two, they'd be fantastic. As is, they're a potential contender, just as they've been in the last few years.
Yeah, and, I was wondering about this in regards to Mike Trout. Does he need to win a World Series in his career with L.A. to really put a stamp on how great he is and put him in there? At the end, when it's all over, assuming health intact, does he have to win it all to be?
No, absolutely not.
He does not.
Not in my mind. No, not in my mind. I mean, maybe for somebody, but, it's not football. It's not a quarterback. The one player does not control the game quite that much. Ted Williams never won a World Series. Nobody thinks about that in terms of his legacy. So, I don't think Mike Trout has to win a World Series. I think he'd like to win one for his own sake, but not for his legacy. He is an all-time great. He is in that category that you mentioned, Mantle, Williams, Cobb. He is not in a category with any current player. So, consider that he had an 8 WAR last year. I think Harper had about a 3 WAR, something like that. It depends how you figure out the WAR, I think. But, this is clearly the best player in the game.
Yeah.
And the Angels have treated him as such, as well they should.
All right, very good. John Heyman, all right, get to work. I look forward to reading you a little bit later on today. Harold Reynolds is on the line right now. And, H, your reaction to this number, where are you, by the way?
I'm actually in Montclair. Got the phone call while I was driving, taking one of my kids to the doctor appointment. Finished that, was taking him back home, and got the call about this contract. I think it's phenomenal. what Mike Trout's been able to do. I think what it represents for me, it's a couple things. One, you got one of the best players in all of baseball. He plays the game right. He puts numbers up. You know, I've heard a lot of talk with Mookie Betts and everybody in the conversation right now, but there's only one Mike Trout. There's nobody in his conversation, period. I mean, he's finishing the final in MVPs every year. You know he's going to be one of the top three. And you can't say that about any other player in baseball. So, to me, there is nobody else to compare this contract to, and that's why the numbers are where they're at. It's kind of eye-popping and shocking right now, but there is nobody else to compare to what this guy's done for 7 years. You know, Mookie's been great for the last couple seasons. Harper's had an MVP. Manny Machado's played well. But nobody's in that conversation every year. We know at the end of the year, Mike Trout's probably going to be in the MVP conversation.
All right, so Harold, the top guys get paid big, big money, hundreds of millions. Now we're seeing a separation, right, between the top and the average major leaguer. And we weren't seeing it this much a few years ago. Is this now the new trend? You pay the big guys out of control money, and the average major leaguer is far below that.
Well, I think that's going to change a little bit. Unfortunately, that's where it's at right now. But whatever what happens in negotiations, and this is where I think some of the rules are going to change, you've always have to be able to compare yourself to the best in a negotiation. And the way it's been structured right now in arbitration, you can only compare yourself to a certain few players. That's not the way it was when I played. And that's the only way it's going to change to bring the bottom back up to more the middle or the top is you got to be able to say, look, if Mike Trout did this, he had 39 home runs, so did I. If Mike Trout did this, so did I. And he's getting paid X, why am I not getting paid closer to that? That's how you negotiate. And so that's how you bring the bottom to the top. Right now, the game is younger. We've got more first year or guys getting minimum paid wages in baseball, which is a lot to the common man. It's $500,000. But to in reference to a guy making $30 million a year, it's not as much. There's a big divide. So the bottom's still got to be brought up a little bit, and I think that will correct itself in time.
Okay, and you're a great guy to ask about this. Put the numbers, put the player aside. Tell us about Mike Trout, the guy.
Well, the guy, one, quiet, unassuming, confident in himself, knows who he is. And you don't say that about many 26, 27-year-olds as they continue to grow and mature. The thing I like about this deal with Trout is he's staying at home. You know, he's been an angel. So I think he's going to continue to be put numbers up immediately. You know, with Harper and Machado, there will be a learning curve. They've both gone to new teams. And in Machado's case, he's gone to a new league. He's going to have to learn. Mike Trout's going to pick up right today in spring training where he was at yesterday. And there's no learning curve. Oh, I got to learn new teammates. I got to learn new manager, a team. System, city, where am I going to live, all that. Throw that out. And Mike Trout will just continue to be who he is. And that's a consistent human being every day. On the field, what I love about Mike Trout, you don't know if it's a game in September that's in a pennant race or if it's April or spring training. He hits a ground ball to short, it's a bang-bang play. So I tell every kid, go watch Mike Trout play. And that's the guy you want carrying that mantle for the game of baseball, that he does everything right. And you want everybody looking at that guy and saying, this is the best player in the game. Go try to be like him. Here he is on a home run. You see him sprinting out of the box. That's Mike Trout every day. He's consistent. And so all these things play into why the Angels pay this kind of money. All that stuff plays into it.
Okay, and finally, before we let you go, how does MLB take advantage of Trout and promote him and promote the game? Do they jump on his back and they say, this is our guy?
Well, I think part of it's already started. You know, the deal with Nike's going to change baseball's world. And Mike Trout being the guy that Nike's putting out there with his own shoe and everything else, this takes that marketing to a whole nother level. So it's not just Major League Baseball. I think it's the other sponsors that are involved in the game as well. We got a long way to go to marketing players. I'm sorry, Mike Trout can walk in the restaurant right here in Montclair, and people will not know who he is. And that's not good for the game, especially when you got a guy you're paying this kind of money. But Mike Trout's not the only one. So we have to get our players out there engaged. You don't see them in a lot of commercial endorsements. We don't see them all over the place. And we got to start promoting the players a little bit more. And I know we promote teams, got to start getting those players out there. So I know that's something that's coming in the collective bargaining agreement. The union has discussed that a lot, and I think the owners are understanding that as well. But if we're going to compete with football, basketball, soccer, all the sports that are out there right now that are number one, baseball cards alone are not going to do it. We got to get those guys pushed out there. And I'm not talking about just Trout and Harper and Machado, but I'm talking about a Lindor, an Altuve, whoever else it might be. We got to push everybody out. And the last thing on that, Matt, I think baseball got a unique platform in that we are able to reach a lot of the world with different languages. So we got to take advantage of all those things.
Yeah.
Congrats to Mike Trout and the Angels. This is phenomenal. I know you got to run.
No, you're the one driving. I'm not going anywhere. We want you to go and be safe. Harold, we thank you very much. Mike Trout.
My little guy Andrew wanted to say he was a big Trout fan. He even got this card this morning, and we went to the store. Can you believe that?
Let me see.
So
you
it's
have
working,
it?
Man.
Do you have a card with you? What is it?
He's got a Mike Trout baseball card, and he just pulled this out of the packet this morning. He was on the cover.
Is that right?
How cool is that?
And I have a feeling. Yeah, and I have a feeling that his dad can get that signed by Mike Trout.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yes.
He says yes.
Let's do it.
Yeah, I think we can make that happen.
All right, guys. Good stuff. You. Goodbye, Harold and family. All right. Some tweets for you here on the Jeff Passan report. He was the first to have this, and we want to give credit where it is due.